Brody Dow, kicking off your home show. Did you enjoy that?
It was brilliant.
You're a great wee boxer, but Victor as well. We both of yous are really going for it, but I think overall, I need to agree, you did well. Did this crowd really get behind you?
It was exciting. I liked it. The crowd was amazing as well.
Is it harder to be first up, or would you rather just get it out of the way?
Being first, it's good if you win, but I think sometimes I box better if I'm off.
Cool, my man. Who are you looking forward to tonight? Who's your mate sort of boxing?
Ali, it's boxing. I know it's his first fight.
Oh, wow. That's Muhammad Ali Bhatti.
Aye.
He's up against Cade and Abernathy. Should be a good bout. So we'll pass back any shout-outs quickly.
I'd like to shout out all the coaches at Blue Vale, Andy, Chris and Kenny. I'd like to shout out my big brother for... if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't beat Blue Vale, so... Big shout out.
Doing amazing, man. Thank you too. You've done well. Jim, we'll see you again.
Aye, obviously. Aye.
That'd be good, mate, to get a wee rematch of that, because both of you got a few bouts under your belt. But you came here. It's not always easy coming to somebody else's home show, but you came here, done the damage. Are we going to see you at the Lanark show at the end of the month?
Probably, yeah. It depends if we find a fight. But
maybe we get a rematch.
Will we?
I don't know.
I'll be there then.
So we'll be there, we'll be live. So I'm looking forward to that. Anybody want?
My mum and my dad over there. Thank you for coming. My brother too for all the help in the garden. Aye, that's it.
Brian Paulus, I'll let you go celebrating your night. I'll see you at the end of the month. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. And as they make their way to the ring, joining me live, JATV Live, is Tyler Knox from McTaggart. Scott, how are you feeling, my man?
Really good, that's my first win. Just really buzzing that I got the fight and got to win it.
You've done amazing, man. I was saying for round one, you're sort of keeping your calm, your composure. I seen Lucas box last week, so I know what he's capable of, but I think you just, as I say, kept that calmness and just looked to execute what you've probably been training in the gym for. So tell us a bit about your training, what you've been practicing.
Well, a lot of just straights and keeping my hands up. But I was doing loads of training, trying to get down to weight.
Just pass back to Greg Rusin in the ring. And as bout number five makes her way to the ring, I'm now joined by the winner of bout number four, Jamie Baird. How are you feeling?
Good, brilliant.
Right from the start, man, you were just consistent and just kept going. I kind of thought TJ kind of took his foot off the gas, but you just never. You were just like relentless through it. Is that what you've been practicing in the gym?
I've been trying to stay really consistent and put a lot of work in. Just be really busy.
This crowd really got behind you. How much has that helped just get you that edge?
I was kind of focused on my opponent, man. I did try to block the crowd out a lot.
Where are we going to see you next?
Don't know, hopefully soon.
And any shout-outs you want to go? I know you got a few people there supporting you. They couldn't sit in their seat there at the end.
Yeah, I would like to get a shout-out to all my friends and family and all my coaches at the club and my club that's helped me through to get this.
Right, my man. You got a few people watching online. I don't know the name. It says Planet Reaper. I don't know who that is, but maybe you know who they are. But they've been supporting you anyway. I'll let you go and celebrate with your friends and family, my man. Jamie Baird, well done in the win, and I'll catch up with you again shortly, yeah? So, we're joined by Rhys Mackay from Kane Boxing. Rhys, I think well deserved win right for the get-go. You just came banging out and then just kept that consistency through it. Was that the game plan?
Not really, I'm not sure.
You just went in and thought just go?
No, Scott Wayne.
What do you think of your opponent?
Yeah, he's good. I fought him before at novices. It was the same band, unanimous decision, but strong boy, so... So
you just like to go boxing? I was saying that you came boxers, you travel here, there and everywhere. You've obviously came down. Where are we going to see you next?
I'm fighting on the Lanark home show on the 29th and then novices again. But that's it, don't know.
Right, man, you've got a few other Kane boxers that are boxing later, innit?
Zane Lawson.
Zane Lawson, that'll be a good bout, innit, with Kyle McGregor.
Zane will win it,
So, anybody want to give a shout out to?
No, really.
All your fans, is there a lot of fans we were watching online?
Kane coaches, and then I see Tyler Ross there, right? I can't him. The fucking.
He's been watching, there we go. Tyler Ross, Thanks for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe, Tyler. I'll be checking up on that. Listen, man, I'll let you go and celebrate. Thanks so much. I'll talk to me. Well done in the win. It was a great one. Well done. Yeah, let's pass back to Greg Houston in the ring. Well, the boxers are making their way to the ring. Just pull your seat in a wee bit, my man. Cruz Kennedy, great matchup between you and Joe from North Glasgow. But you look confident throughout. How are you feeling?
I feel unbelievable, man. Look at the atmosphere. It's unbelievable. I'm so happy.
Isn't it? Like, I know you've got a lot of fans here as well. Like, I grabbed you quickly before they had a chance to start pulling you away for hugs and kisses and all that. Where are we going to see you next? What's the plan of the year?
Well, we're going to Belfast in October, and then we've got the Scottish, got to win that, and then hopefully the British win that or not.
Right, my man. What did you think of your opponent, Joe?
Joe's a good boxer. You know what I mean, he's a year older, good back foot boxer, but I knew I had to come front foot and beat him at his in game, and that's what I done.
Right, anybody want to give a shout out to?
Yeah, I want to give a shout out to all my coaches: Chris, Andy, Kenny, Ricky, Edgar, everyone, and all my everyone's came out to see me, and my gran and all who's in the house. It's good.
Right, my man, listen, I'll let you go celebrate. Great boxing, man. And I'll catch up with you shortly. Yeah, take care. That was Cruz Kennedy. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. Alex, how did you find that? You enjoy it?
Yeah, I loved every second of it. You know, I was starting to get tired in the rounds, but I guess you just got to push, man. That's what you get with boxing. Got to be mentally tough in that. I've got to give it to the other guy. He put in his heart in. Man, I just got to give it to him, man. He was a good boxer.
He's both had your moments in there. It did come down to a split decision. What was going through your mind when you heard that? Because what do you think?
I was a little bit nervous about the split decision, you know. Because, like, he boxed well, yeah. At the first round, I didn't even realise he was a southpaw. That's the problem. So I think, like, I lost the first round because of that. I don't know if I lost the first round, but, like, I think, like, you know, I didn't know who he was. I don't know if he was southpaw or Ducks. I couldn't tell.
Hey, where are we going to see you next?
When you go see me next, I might ask Andy, you know, shout out to him. I might get him to get me a fight in a week or something. Because, you know, I'm trying to get like 3 fights before the novices. Know what I'm saying?
Right, and anybody want to give a shout out to?
My dad. He's the one that came here. Also, coaches here. Thanks for being there. I also probably shout out to my school. If it wasn't for my school, you know, Lincoln and Blue Veil, I probably wouldn't even be here boxing. I'd probably be somewhere else. I'd probably be sitting in my room playing games or something, doing nothing with my life, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, stick it to boxing, man. We want to see Mary. That was brilliant. I'll let you go and celebrate. Everybody's gone for a wee interval. Just now. But listen, thanks for talking to me. Brilliant boxing. And I'll look forward to seeing you again, my man. Cheers, bro. So, guys, just before we go into that bout, to Kenya, Scottish Boxer of the Year as well. Nobody wants to box, you know. You have to get exhibitions. What's that about?
I really wanted to fight today, I can't lie, but I'm still grateful to be able to fight someone like him. He's a good boxer, yeah. But yeah.
So Jordan was... Oh, you fucked the line. Jordan is a tough opponent. It was good that he came in. He got an exhibition in front of your eye. He came in and got it in front of your friends and family and all. How's your support been for the crowd?
That's amazing. I just hear them shouting in the T, yeah.
And how's the training in the gym going?
Amazing. I want to shout out to my coaches, Andy, Chris, Kevin.
Event, and then he's like, oh, you come to Blueville? And I went, I want to come. So last week, a few of your boys were boxing.
Lord, in my opinion.
And it's weird because two of my aunts just stay like within a few settings for this place. Next year, if you have it here, I'll just stay with one of theirs and stay out for the party.
We appreciate you coming here, man. Yeah.
So anybody else you want to give a shout out to?
My mom, my dad, and everybody that came to support.
Right, man, listen, take you, Kenya. I love watching you, man, and I'll catch up with you very, very shortly. Let's pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. And just before we go on to bout number 11, Zane Lawson. Quite a tough bout, but you handled yourself well throughout. Came out as by decision in the end, but what's your thoughts?
I thought I did more than enough to win. I thought my movement and pivots in the first round won me the first, and then after that it started getting a bit more scrappy. But I thought I definitely won it. But I know he's just coming off his silver GBs at the GBs, so I knew that'd be a really good scrap. I knew it'd be a really hard fight.
Quite earlier on in the first round, I was seeing big shots land and you were throwing them, and like, I could feel them even on the way back here. But a great box I watched. That's probably my favourite bout of the night, because the two of you just sort of gave it your all. But where are we going to see you next?
I'm hoping to do intermediates, do the opens next year, get gold at both of those, and try out for the British team. As soon as I get onto that British team, gonna keep progressing, only gonna get better. So that's what I'm hoping to do this season.
Wait, my man, any shout outs you want to give?
I know Tyler Ross's, I heard you on the stream earlier. Yeah, Tyler, big man.
Wait, my man. I know you've got long to travel, man, so yeah. Safe journey back and I'll catch up with you shortly, man. But brilliant boxing. See you later. That was Zane Lawson. And just as they'll make their way to the ring, Aaron, great performance, man. What's your thoughts on it?
It was a good fight. That guy was quite tough, short notice as well. Found it out on the Tuesday, I had to cut loads of weight, but quite happy with the performance.
What about your opponent? What's your thoughts on Kyle? Put each other through your paces and really test yourself, but I agree completely with the decision. I think you've done more than enough to get the three rounds to win. Where are we going to see you next?
Oh, I don't know. Just whenever Terry gets a fight, really, that's it.
And anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Mum and Dad. They moaned last time I never gave them one, so.
Well, man, I'll let you go, sir, mate. Thanks for talking to me. Well done in the win. Passed by Gregory Houston in the ring. Hercules. You getting paid by the minute or something? Well,
I've been wanting to do this for so long.
But the interview or the interview? Is that why you ended it so fast?
This is why I was like.
What's your thoughts? I know you've just, you're barely, hadn't you?
I was coming here to, I was coming here to win. I wasn't coming here to play. I've been training so hard since my last fight at the Wheel and Wallace. This new season, I'm coming for everyone, I want to give a shout out to my club, Blueville. I want to give a shout out to Coach Kenny. Coach Andy, he's not here. And Chris, he's been a really good help, good support for me, All the coaches. Big Stevie. Big shout out to the Blueville team. Love it. Enjoyed it. Good show.
Oh, my man. Let's all go celebrate.
Thanks
so much. I look forward to seeing you during the rear.
Thank you, sir.
Take care, pal. That was Hercules Camden. Johnny B. Ringside. Swayb and Abe, that's definitely the bout of the night so far. Absolute belter. The two of you really put everything into it. What's your thoughts?
I wasn't throwing my jab enough. I know that, man. My left arm was getting the hot, but it was all right. But I just didn't throw my jab enough. And I feel like if I threw a jab more, I would have won that easier. But obviously another, and that's what I'm just learning at the end of the day, you know what I mean?
It seemed that towards the end, the sort of stamina was sort of reducing that. You'd sort of just upped your game, just kept at that level consistently. Is that what you were finding in the ring?
Second round, I felt his stamina dropped. I tried to tell the body mill, but then I think he clicked onto it. He started blocking me. But it was a good fight.
Are we going to see that again?
Hopefully, man.
It was brilliant, man. Everybody was going. Where my senior brother in as well? Jakey gets nervous watching you.
I don't know. A wee bit.
How were you when you watch him?
A wee bit nervous.
Any shout-outs you want to give?
My coach at Blueville, Chris, Andy, Kenny, Edgar, Ricky, and all that.
Brilliant, my man. Listen, I'll let you go celebrate. Brilliant performance, man. Can't wait to see you again. Don't leave it too long either. Do I wait too long, my man? Thank you, bro. Take care of you. So, guys, just before we go, I hope you've enjoyed the night. We've got comments coming in. Cormac Wallace, you know who that is? So, Aidy Turnup, main event in Blueville's home show. It's not always easy coming to somebody else's home show, main eventing, but after that, about, and it was a 4-1 split at the end, but I think the two of you done amazing, and I can't agree, for me, you're more consistent throughout. How you feeling?
Fucked, man. I'm down, so I'm not swearing, but nah, mate, it's my first fight back in like a year and a half, man. I was way up at uni and that, but I feel class, man. I just want to keep getting in there and keep fighting.
So, right, man, I know Mark will be taking you here, there, and everywhere. So don't leave it too long before we see you. But how's it been in the gym, getting back into it, training?
Oh, class. I mean, it's so good. I mean, we've got so many top boys there to spar with, and we all push each other on. It's just such a good atmosphere in the gym, man, and even they're all up here supporting the night. And
Dumfries is a hefty boxing city.
Oh, isn't it?
Right, I remember when I came down for your show last year, it was like, people were talking about it. It was like, and I suppose that was your first show last year in 14 years. I know you've got another one. It's going to be coming up when the books gets confirmed. But the support you get locally as well as fans that are even travelling. I know you get some of your boys with you. What does that mean for you?
Oh, it's everything. I mean, it's class just having all the boys here with Mark and that. Mark does so much to drive us up and down everywhere to sparring and that, and it's just class. I mean, they kind of spurred me on tonight, you know, it's just so good.
Just squeeze up, we'll manage.
One of the grassroots boxers, this boy started with Nith Valley, hadn't he put a pair of gloves on, and he's been out for a couple of years. Thought he'd be a wee bit rusty, but in the other night he done brilliant. That's top of the bill.
Yeah, brilliant, top man. Lad. So where are we going to see you next?
Just as soon as possible, hopefully.
You have you on Sunday. get a rest, get back in the gym. Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
My mum, my dad, Daniel, Cormac, Jack, Lewis, just, I don't know, man. I'm Mark, the goat, Mark and Scott, just everyone.
Brilliant, man. Listen, Aidan, brilliant to see you back. As I say, don't leave it too long to be see you again. Thanks so much, Mark. As always, catch up with you shortly, yeah? Cheers. And while the boxers are making their way to the ring, just come in a wee bit, my man. Brody Dow, kicking off your home show. Did you enjoy that?
Aye, it was brilliant.
You're a great wee boxer, but Victor as well. Both of you are really going for it, but I think overall, I need to agree, you did well. Did this crowd really get behind you?
It was exciting. I liked it. The crowd was amazing as well.
Is it harder to be first up, or would you rather just get it out of the way?
Being first, it's good if you win, but I think sometimes I box better if I'm like third or fourth.
Cool, my man. Who are you looking forward to tonight? Who's your mates that are boxing?
Ali, that's boxing and it's his first fight.
Oh, wow. That's Muhammad Ali Bhatti.
Aye.
He's up against Caden Abernathy. Should be a good bout. So we'll pass back any shout-outs quickly.
I'd like to shout out all the coaches at Bluefield, Andy, Chris and Kenny. I'd like to shout out my big brother if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be at Bluefield. So, big shout out to him and shout out to my mum and my dad.
Hey man, I seen they were there waiting for you, so I'll let you go celebrate. Thank you so much for talking to me, and I'll catch up with you again shortly. Yeah? Let's pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. So, we've got a quick minute to speak to Caden. Caden, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling good after that win.
Bro, I think you started getting into your rhythm towards the end of round number one. After that, you were just relentless, man, pushing forward. That was his first Bouncy's debut. How many are you on?
Just one, no, Scottish.
That's your second one. Bro, that was you're doing amazing, man. Thank you too, you've done well. Jim, we'll see yous again.
Aye, obviously. Aye.
That'll be good, mate, to get a wee rematch of that, because both of yous got a few bouts under your belt, but you came here. It's not always easy coming to somebody else's home show, but you came here, done the damage. Are we going to see you at the Lanark show at the end of the month?
Probably, yeah. It depends if I find a fight. But
maybe we get a rematch.
Will we?
I don't know.
I'll be there then.
So we'll be there, we'll be live. So I'm looking forward to that. Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
My mum and my dad over there. Thank you for coming. My brother too for all the help in the garden. Aye, that's it.
Brian Palace, I'll let you go celebrate and join night. I'll see you at the end of the month. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. And as they make their way to the ring, joining me live, JTV Live, is Tyler Knox from McTaggart. Scott, how you feeling, my man?
Really good, that's my first win. Just really buzzing that I got the fight and got to win it.
You done amazing, man. I was saying for round one, you're sort of keeping your calm, your composure. I seen Lucas box last week, so I know what he's capable of, but I think you just, as I say, kept that calmness and just looked to execute what you've probably been training in the gym for. So tell us a bit about your training, what you've been practicing.
Well, a lot of just straights and keeping my hands up, but I was doing loads of training trying to get down to the actual weight, trying to get down to it, but it was just a loads of straights and backhands and loads of fitness, because last couple of fights I wasn't as fit.
And what do you think of Lucas?
He was really good. I sparred him a couple of weeks before that. And he was really good. I really thought when he said 3-2, he was going to give it to him, being his show, but I'm really happy I got it.
That's always in the back of your mind, isn't it? But listen, I thought it did come down to a split decision, but for me, you've done enough to win it consistently throughout the three rounds. Where are we going to see you next?
Don't know. Novices. Going to win that too.
All right, my man, that'll be up in October, I think the 13th, 14th of October. And anybody I give a shout out to?
Just Sandy, and especially Conor Anderson. He helped me the most.
Always for a picture. There we go, man. I'll let you go celebrate. You can jump down that way, and I'll catch you shortly. Let's pass back to Greg Houston in the ring. And as bout number five makes her way to the ring, I'm now joined by the winner of bout number four, Jamie Baird. How are you feeling?
Good, brilliant.
Right from the start, man, you were just consistent and just kept going. I kind of thought TJ kind of took his foot off the gas, but you just never. You were just like relentless through it. Yeah. Is that what you've been practicing in the gym?
I've been trying to stay really consistent and put a lot of work in. Just be really busy.
This crowd really got behind you. How much has that helped just get you that edge?
I was kind of focused on my opponent, man. I did try to block the crowd out.
Where are we going to see you next?
Don't know, hopefully soon.
And any shout-outs you want to go? I know you got a few people there supporting you. They couldn't sit in their seat there at the end.
Yeah, I would like to get a shout-out to all my friends and family and all my coaches at the club and my club that's helped me through to get this.
Right, my man. You got a few people watching online. I don't know the name. It says Planet Reaper. I don't know who that is, but maybe you know who they are. But they've been supporting you anyway. I'll let you go and celebrate. With your friends and family, my man, Jamie Baird, well done in the win, and I'll catch up with you again shortly, yeah? So, we're joined by Rhys Mackay from Kane Boxing. Rhys, I think well-deserved win, right from the get-go. You just came banging out and then just kept that consistency through it. Was that the game plan?
Not really, I'm not sure.
You just went in and thought, just go?
No, just got win.
What do you think of your opponent?
Yeah, he's good. I fought him before at novices, and yeah. It was the same band, unanimous decision, but some boy, so.
So you just like to go boxing? I was saying that you came boxers, you travel here, there, and everywhere. You've obviously came down. Where are we going to see you next?
I'm fighting on the Wanart home show on the 29th, and then novices again. But that's it, don't know.
Right, man, you've got a few other Kane boxers that are boxing later, innit?
Zane Lawson.
Zane Lawson, that'll be a good bout, innit, with Kyle McGregor.
Zane will win it.
So, anybody want to give a shout out to?
Not really. It's
all your fans, there's a lot of fans we were watching online.
Kane coaches, and then I see Tyler Ross there, I can't him.
He's been watching, there we go, Tyler Ross. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe, Tyler. I'll be checking up on that. Listen, man, I'll let you go and celebrate. Thanks so much for talking to me. Well done in the win. It was a great one. Well done, yeah. Let's pass back to Greg Houston in the ring. Well, the boxers are making their way to the ring. Just pull your seat in a wee bit, my man. Cruz Kennedy, great matchup between you and Joe from off Glasgow. But you look confident throughout. How are you feeling?
I feel unbelievable, man. Look at the atmosphere, it's unbelievable, I'm so happy.
Isn't it? Like, I know you've got a lot of fans here as well. Like, I grabbed you quickly before they had a chance to start pulling you away for hugs and kisses and all. Where are we going to see you next? What's the plan of the year?
Well, we're going to Belfast in October, and then we've got the Scottish, got to win that, and then hopefully the British win that and all.
Right, my man. What did you think of your opponent, Joe?
Joe's a good boxer, you know what I mean? He's a year older, good back foot boxer, but I knew I had to come front through and beat him at his in game, and that's what I done.
Right, anybody want to give a shout out to?
Yeah, I want to give a shout out to all my coaches, Chris, Andy, Kenny, Ricky, Edgar, everyone and all my...
Thank you. So hello, good morning and welcome to JATV Live's coverage of the Western District versus the North West of England. We're almost ready to go. Our ring announcer in the ring is Mr. Gregory Houston. The officials are at ringside. We'll have a quick look at what we've got coming up just before Greg speaks. Some changes to the card, but first up will be Harris Maguire, and he's boxing Ollie Jamilie Jonovis. I think I said that right. I should have read through these names before I came on. I do know that bout number four is off due to a late pullout of the Northwest boxer. As I said, we're almost ready to go. Let me know in the comments where you're watching from, who you're supporting. We'll give you some shout-outs. Cameron Ray, to answer your question, we're just about ready, maybe in the next few minutes. Ring announcer Gregory Houston is in the ring. See some of the officials there. And hopefully the live stream looks so far so good. That's that decision made. So it means we'll get the winners facing us, which is always good. We don't always get it. So I'll be back in just a moment. We'll leave you with the ring cam here.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome to the Antonine Boxing Gym, where today the Western District is proud to bring you a season-opener special event featuring boxers from Scotland's Western District against a North West England select. We're going to get our first bout in the ring just shortly. As always, we do ask you to cheer our boxers on. But we do ask, no booing, no abuse towards the boxers. They're here representing their districts. They're not paid to be in this ring. So show each and every one of our boxers today the respect they deserve. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our first two boxers to the ring.
So our boxers are making their way to the ring. First up, Harris Maguire from the Western District is boxing Ollie Jamilie Jonovis. Don't forget, if you are watching online, click like and subscribe. You do get to get updates in future live streams. So Ollie will be boxing out of the red corner and Harris out of the blue. Shout to Paul Cushion, who's watching online again, and Team York Hill. They'll be on a little bit later. Let's pass to Gregory Houston in the ring as we introduce both boxers.
Ladies and gentlemen, our officials today are appointed by the Western District of Boxing Scotland. Our ring supervisor is Mr. Jim Sterling, timekeeper at the bell, Mr. Ryan O'Rourke, and our medical officer at ringside is Dr. Scott Henderson. We begin today with a 39-kilo schoolboy contest over 3 one-minute rounds. And when the bell rings, our international star referee in charge, please welcome from Airdrie, Mr. George Brown. Introducing first in the red corner, wearing blue shorts with white, representing North West England, Ollie Jamilie Jonovis. And in the blue corner, wearing white shorts with sky blue, representing Scotland's Western District, Harris Maguire! 3 one-minute rounds.
So this is 3 one-minute rounds. As I said, let us know in the comments where you're watching from. Harris McGuire in the blue corner, and Ollie Jimilia Jonavis in the red. Very fast start for both boxers there. You will find this is 3 1-minute rounds, so won't be a lot of time for the boxers to pick up points. Nice right there, landing in the blue corner as Ollie continues to push forward. I guess it's quite a good matchup. They both boxers seem very similar in style. Final 10 seconds of round number one. And a great wee start to this afternoon.
Filming, please make sure the light or flash is off on your phone or camera.
Both boxers. Got a lot of energy. Sometimes difficult to see where points are getting picked up. But I've definitely seen both of them land. We'll see if they can maybe slow down in the next few rounds. But you know what it's like. There's what happens in round number one doesn't determine what's going to happen in the next two rounds. So I think quite an even first round there. And we'll see what happens as we go into round number two. So we've got into round number two. Well, these two just picking up where they left off. Harris using those straight jabs, that left jab landing a few times. He's got Ollie looking to pick his shots, continuing to be light in his toes, holding that middle ring. Nice left right there landing on the boxer in blue. But Ollie determined to break through. Great work there from the Northwest boxer. Again, nice style again from Harris. Great work there again, another close round, but if I had to so we've picked that one up, I'd need to go with the blue corner. Possibly still want to play for going into round number three. But Harris beginning to find his rhythm a bit, throwing that left right and landing quite nicely. Ollie, the red corner, sheer determination coming from him, so that's why I think it could be close. Just depends what the judges are seeing at ringside. As always, I do not know the scores. And I'll find out the winner when you find out. So just about to go back into round number three, third and final round. I think all he knows, he needs to up his game. He's kept that great work rate throughout. Harris using that ring space to dodge his opponent as he comes forward. Getting tangled up here and there. Final 10 seconds of round number three, and then we will have a winner for you. Great work there. We'll pass straight to Gregory Houston in the ring with the official announcement here for bout number one.
Ladies and gentlemen, please let's hear it from both boxers. After three rounds, the winner by unanimous decision in the blue corner. And please let's hear it for all.
And just before we got to the next round, Paul, you're seeing a wee bit, my man. Oh, the other way. There we go. Harris Maguire, great performance there, man. Do you enjoy that?
Aye, I loved it, man.
It's not always easy being first up. Just watch my board, man. All your team are falling in. Sorry, we can see you, though. What's it like having a squad at this lot?
It's brilliant, man. It's always good to go. Like, know someone else's show. It's always good to go somewhere and then beat them at their own game.
Boy, man, I thought your rhythm started to kick in, I think, for round number one. I thought it was a bit close. Number two, round number two, your rhythm started, that you were thrown at left and right. Is that what your coaches are telling you in the corner?
Yeah, just had to keep the pressure on them. That's my first fight back after a while because I broke my wrist and that, but I'm just delighted I got the win.
So where are we going to see you next, man?
The novices.
Got to take me a gold there.
Aye.
Let's move. I'll catch you later on.
Introducing first boxing out of the red corner. Wearing blue shorts with white, representing Northwest England, Jaden Carruthers. And in the blue corner, wearing white shorts with green, representing Scotland's Western District, Joseph McIndoe.
3 1.5 minute rounds. You're watching JATV Live's coverage of the Western District of Scotland versus the Northwest of England. This is Joseph McIndoe, North Glasgow boxer, and Jaden Carruthers. Shout out to Cruz Kennedy, who's watching online. I hope you recovered from the other night. So go round number one. Quick start from Jaden in the red, but Joseph using that ring space well. We have seen Joseph already this season. He's a boxer looking to have a busy season. Nice double jab there from Joseph. But Jaden continuing to follow him around the ring. But Joseph using that sidestep well. I think we're cameraman struggling to keep up. Just so you know, the camera has been operated by young people from JATV Goals. It's a youth mentoring project we've set up to work with young people. And a few of them have picked to work with us at JATV Live. Last 10 seconds of round number one. Better turn my mic up. It's another competitive bout. This is 3 1.5 minute rounds. So let me just sort my technical stuff in the background there. Oh, there we go. So 3 1.5 minute rounds, just about got to round number two. This is bout number two. Joseph McIndoe and Jaden Carruthers. Nice left right there, landing from the red corner. Joseph returns a few of his own. Great work by both boxers. As far as his best, I don't know how they're going to score it. Both doing so well. So if you're watching from the northwest of England, how you lot doing? Hope you can understand my accent. I've tried to tone it down the Glaswegian a bit. Don't forget you can watch all this back later on JATV's YouTube channel. And if anyone wants to order any individual bouts, they're priced at £35. We can edit them and post them on their own. Big shots are landing from the red corner as Joseph now retires with some of his own. Very, very close round. I've seen both of them landing again. I would need to say, I think the retaliation from Joseph picked him up possibly a bit more points, but the aggression coming from the red corner, that's just depends what the judges are seeing and what they're looking for, I suppose. That's why I would never be a judge. Can barely manage being a commentator. We've got to round number three, third and final round for bout number two. Joseph McIndoe in the blue corner and Jaden Carruthers in the red. Could all come down to this. Great work rate again from the red corner. Joseph dodged it there and swung nicely. Bit different styles. Joseph just been reminded to keep his head up, his corner centre, to keep his shape. Great uppercut there, landing from the blue corner. He's got a body as well. We don't always see that in the Olympic style boxing, especially these short rounds. But a big shot to the body could end the bout. Now, I have seen Joseph before. If it needs to come down to a scrap, he'll get engaged in a scrap. But he does prefer a box. Red corner, force him against the ropes. Final 10 seconds around number three. Wow, what a great round there. See the respect there from both boxers. Pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring with an official announcement. Next up, we will have Michael Campbell and Jacob Waring.
Gentlemen, please, let's hear it for both boxers. After three rounds, the winner on a 4-1 split decision in the blue corner, Jason McIndoe.
Well done to Jason there. I think it's well deserved one.
For Jaden Carruthers.
We'll have Jaden here in just a second. But also, Jaden Carruthers, great effort. Really keeping that momentum up from start to finish. We'll have Joseph here in just a second. I know his mum was watching online, so his dad's here, his mum. I was watching the stream. I hope you enjoyed that. Be proud of him. And here he comes. Joseph, if you just pull your seat in a wee bit and you're speaking into that mic, man. You've not had a lot of time to catch your breath.
No.
How did you find that? You enjoy it?
He was constantly pushing me back, but I just thought I'd took control of the line.
Was a bit of a different clash of styles.
I know.
He was like very aggressive coming
constantly,
forward.
I know.
But you started to find your rhythm. You're taking that step back, throwing the left jab to retaliate against his. And I just thought your accuracy
last
was strong.
I just tried to dig it in.
Aye, I know. I was thinking like it's 3.5 rounds, but 3 1.5 minute rounds. But for you to keep that momentum up, your adrenaline's gone. It's difficult. But you're proud to get the win.
Aye, because I had a loss on Friday, I think, you were there.
I was saying that, I was like, you've already had a busy season, the season's just started. Where are we going to see you next?
Maybe some club shows, but I'm fighting in the Scottish, and then hopefully the British.
Boy, man, boy, you've been, the improvement I've seen in like the last year to now, you're just more comfortable in the ring, and I can compare you to some of these boxers like Robert McNulty, even Leo Church, for Antonine, there's a style they have in the ring, it's just, the execute's brilliant. Just before we go back in the ring, any shout-outs right again?
I thank my coach and Dastan for helping me in the corner, and like my dad and all that for coming and watching me.
And your mum watching online?
Aye.
I'll let you go celebrate, thanks for talking, I'll catch up soon, yeah? That was Joseph McIndoe picking up the win there. Let's pass to Gregory Houston in the ring.
Corner, wearing red shorts with white, representing Northwest England, Jacob Waring. And in the blue corner, wearing the blue shorts with yellow, representing Scotland's Western District, Michael Campbell. 3 1.5 minute rounds.
So this again, 3 1.5 minute rounds. Josh Sharp from Northwest England in the red corner. Oh, sorry, Jacob Waring from Northwest England in the red corner. Michael Campbell in the blue. We go round number one. And Michael Campbell is a boxer we've seen plenty of times in JATV Live. But already I can see Jacob in the red is as comfortable in the ring as Michael is. Great work from both so far. Nice use of the left jab there in the red corner. Michael throwing his right and then stepping back. Great style. You see how quickly he moves in and out, but Jacob as well is just anticipating what's coming. As the first round, so they seem to be sussing each other out a bit. Young Michael is friends with my younger cousin, Robbie. So shout out to Robbie Weir. If you're not watching live, I'll send you the link later. You can watch it back. International star referee there, Jim Smith. And the ring with the boxers. Final 10 seconds of round number one. Nice work there from the boxer in red. Jacob Wearing. They're getting caught up in the ropes. But the bell's just about to sound. So, very well paced first round. Like both boxers, as I said, try to suss each other out, but just towards the end there, Jacob just took it up a gear. Michael very comfortable in the ring. Can see that Jacob is as well, but be interested to see what happens as we go into round number two. You're watching JT Live's coverage of the Western District of Scotland versus North West England. And this is hosted at Antonine Boxing Club in Dalmuir, which is just out of Clydebank, not too far from Glasgow. We'll pass back in the ring as we get ready for round number two. Trip there, I think Jim Smith calls it trip as well. It just sometimes amazes me how comfortable you can see two boxers in the ring that they've kept their composure. Good as I know Michael is, I'm watching Jacob and just sheer awe. He's getting his rhythm nicely, picking his shots. I can see a sheer look. A focus and determination in Jacob's eyes. He's kept that focus. He's getting a wee bit lippy with the referee there. They won't put up with that. So he just needs to calm himself a bit. I have seen matches stopped because people. I'm just going to move my chair. There we go. I'm fed up moving my chair up. But I've seen the bout stopped if there's some lip given back to the referees. But Jacob maybe got a bit frustrated there, but he's doing well. He just needs to keep his calm. Bite down on that gum shield. And we'll see what happens in round number three. I think first round's a bit even for me. That round definitely the red corner. And we'll see what's going to happen as we go into round number three here at Antonine Boxing Club, who's hosting the Western District of Scotland versus North West England. This event, as well as all our JATV Live sponsors you see on the screen, Kelvin Side Motor Company is supporting this live stream themselves. So we go third and final round. Yeah. Jacob, now just hold him back ever so slightly, keeping that composure, just looking when he leads with that left and then follow up with the right. Michael is attempting to break that rhythm. Continuing to stay in this bout. Here we go with the third round final bell. Great work there from both boxers. We'll see what the judges think as we go back in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it from both boxers! After three rounds, the winner on a 4-1 split decision. In the red corner, Jacob Wynn! And please, let's hear it from Michael Campbell!
And just as those boxers are making their way, Jacob, who just won bout number three, fantastic performance. I was in awe watching you. The whole, when you got into your rhythm, you won it like the first two bouts. You won it like just going for it and throwing left hooks. You were keeping your composure. I know you're just at the ring, but what's your thoughts in the bout?
It was pretty easy, but it was a good fighter.
You got a bit frustrated there at times with the referee. He told you you had to watch your lip. I have seen bouts stop because, but what was it? You just get a bit frustrated.
Yeah, he kept holding my arm, then the ref said I was holding. So.
Who you got here supporting you?
My dad and my brother.
And anybody watching at home?
I don't know.
Don't know. Anybody want to give a shout out to?
My dad.
Right, my man. Listen, Jacob, thank you so much for coming, and I hope to see you again, man.
Yeah.
All right, take care. That was Jacob Waring, winner of bout number three. Guys, you're watching JATV Live's coverage of the Western District of Scotland versus North West England.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue with a 54-kilo schoolboy contest over three 1.5-minute rounds. The referee is Mr. Jim Smith. Boxing out of the red corner, wearing blue shorts with white, representing North West England, J.P. Miller. And in the blue corner, wearing white shorts with gold and red, representing Scotland's Western District, Cooper Irvin. 1.5-minute rounds.
So this is bout number four of the afternoon, but bout number five on the programme. We did have bout number four. It was cancelled due to a late pullout. So we'll round number one, JP Miller from Northwest England in the red corner. And he's boxing Cooper Irvine from the Western District in the blue. Again, first round, just boxers just sussing each other out, testing each other. I've seen Cooper box a lot. I know what he's capable of, but again, already JP Miller looks like he can hold his own. He's leading in there with that straight jab. Cooper doing well to block that left hand as it comes. Final 10 seconds of round number one. And another very, very nice opening round. As I said, both boxers sort of just testing each other out, looking to see where they can get through. Obviously, a clear difference in stances. But yeah, it's looking up to be quite an exciting one. So we've got comments coming in. James Boyle, how you doing? Max, FABC. Cruz Kennedy's watching online. Kian Leo. LDOC27 and Carson Short, hope you're enjoying the show. Don't forget to click like, and you can click subscribe to keep up to date with future JATV Live streams. Let's pass back in the ring. We're going to round number two. Cooper Irvine, boxing side of New York Hill Boxing Club. Shout out to everyone at New York Hill. Nice work there from JP Miller in the red. Cooper looks to retaliate to that. Either way, Cooper just instinctively raises that right hand to anticipate what's coming towards him. Great boxing there for the red corner as well. Just needs to use that ring space a bit more. Don't get caught up in the corner. But as I said, he is blocking a lot. So be interesting to see what the judges are seeing. But there are a few shots coming through there from JP Miller in the red, right at the end of that round there. Got a question coming in from Callum Elliott, asking what weight this is. 54 kg. What are you looking for about? So one more round left about number five on the card. We'll have a wee quick look at what we've got coming up next. There is some changes to this. I don't know which the second bout was. There's another bout that's been pulled out. But according to the card, next up, Kai Hendry and Cole Price. West Pass back, we're going to round number three. Cooper staying back and boxing on the back foot. He's responding to his opponent's bringing towards him, making it difficult as well to land. I said, if you keep an eye on that right hand to Cooper, he instinctively raises it to try and halt any shots getting through from his opponent. Yeah, JP Miller, fantastic stamina. He just kept up that pace throughout. Again, very determined look. Final few seconds of round number three, and we'll have a winner for you. Well done there, both boxers. You see the respect there between them. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring as we find out the winner of bout number five in the card between Cooper Irvine from the Western District of Scotland versus JP Miller's Northwest England.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it from both boxers! After three rounds, the winner on a 4-1 split decision in the red corner, JP Miller! And please, let's hear it for Cooper Irvine!
And just before we got into that round, JP Miller, fantastic performance. You kept that momentum up from start to finish. No, it was an easy boxer to box. He can be a bit difficult himself. He was boxing the back foot, but you just kept going. What's your thoughts in the bout?
Well, he's got to keep on going. It was a good, tough fight. Strong kid. He's got to keep on pushing through.
So it came down to a 4-1 split decision. I think depending on where the judges would have been, they maybe would have seen you landing a bit more on him, maybe blocking or whatever. But you think that was a fair decision in the end?
I think it was a fair decision because didn't do too much in the last round. I should have stepped up a bit more, but I am happy with the decision.
So where are we going to see you next? What's your year looking like? Where are you going to be competing?
I haven't got any belts on the board, but I've got England training on the 1st of October, so that'll be good.
Right, man, anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Jimmy, Jamie, the coaches, and everyone here at the support.
Right, my man, let's let you go celebrate. Well done, thanks for coming up. We'll see you again shortly, yeah?
Over 3 2-minute rounds. The referee in charge, please welcome from Bells Hill, international star referee, Mr. John McKenna. Introducing first, boxing out of the red corner, wearing red shorts, wear the white, representing Northwest England, Troy Weary. And in the blue corner, wearing the dark blue shorts with sky blue trim, representing Scotland's Western District, William Moore. 3 2-minute rounds.
So this is bout number 7 on the card, Leo Moohan versus Troy Wearing. I'm showing some issues with the stream, so just let us know in the comments if you're having any issues. We'll try to refresh the settings. The signal was a bit touch and go. It looks alright now, but just let me know in the comments how we're getting on. With me, I know some of you are having some buffering issues. We will try to send a low resolution signal out, so just give me a wee second to leave you with the ring cam until we do that. This is round number 2, Troy Wearing in the red corner. We've adjusted the setting slightly to try, we're just having some stream issues. So hopefully that resolves any buffering you're having, but we will put any bouts, there is streaming issues, back online later so you can watch them.
Yeah.
So I've been a bit quiet as I just focus on some of the technical questions we're having, but it looks as though the reduced quality, as maybe I spoke too soon. Let me know how the stream is going. There was a wee bit juddering there my end. So just let us know in the comments if you're coming across any issues, and we can try and just refresh the settings and see how we go. It's showing us excellent connection here, but that doesn't mean you're getting an excellent connection, so just keep me updated in the comments. Any issues with the stream, then later on today we'll post those bouts. You can order edits of the bouts, so they're £35. You can do that through our website at jatvlive.com/PPV. Or you can just go to jatvlive.com and click buy a bout. It said there's the details of what bout you want. We're at the third and final round here for bout number 7 on the card. Troy Waring from Northwest England is facing Liam Moohan from the Western District of Scotland. Try again, powering forward as Liam lands in the gloves. International star referee John McKenna in the ring with both boxers. Nice straight there landing from the red corner. I'm guessing he's the brother of Jacob Waring, who picked up the win about number 3 on the card. We're just doing well to keep that guard up, and when Liam is responding to him, just forcing him to land in the gloves. Nice left there landing from Liam. Final few seconds around number 3, and then we'll find out who our judges have scored the winner. Okay, what we'll pass to Gregory Houston in the ring with the official announcement here for bout number 7 on the card.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it for both boxers! After 3 rounds, the winner by unanimous decision, in the blue corner, Liam Moohan! And please, let's hear it for Troy Waring! Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our next 2 boxers!
So just before we go into that interview, just before we go into the next round, Liam, unanimous decision, did you agree with that?
Yeah, I thought I'd done enough to win it. Very close fight though, but felt as if last round I was landing the bigger punches, so...
Very, very good boxer, you know what I mean? I think his brother was boxing earlier as well. The two of them must be training at home and sparring at home, because they're really, really good to watch. But I think you just kept the pace going. You were trying to break them down. Sometimes landing in the gloves, but then I seen you throwing that jab down the middle. Where are we going to see you next, my man?
Not too sure. Hopefully, I'm in like the next generation Scotland team, so I'm hoping to get away with them sometime. If not, then next year the Scottish next up, so.
Right, my man, where are we going to see you next?
Scottish. So, Scotland.
That's amazing. Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Just my coaches, my friends and family, and the bar head team that came to watch me today.
Right, my man, let you go celebrate. Thank you. Yeah, I'll speak to you shortly. We're going to have a wee chat with Troy Waring. Troy, I couldn't let you go after talking to you. I thought you boxed brilliantly. Unanimous decision doesn't mean it wasn't close. I don't know what the scorecards were, but I think it could have been close. You definitely kept your composure. You and your brother, is it your brother that was boxing earlier? Well, you still are brilliant. What's your thoughts on about?
I thought he was a better boxer. I was stronger. A great fighter, and I think we should have it again down in England.
I see that you were guarding a lot. I don't know if the judges were seeing that. Like, you had your guards up when he was thrown at you and he'd done the gloves. We'll keep talking. Where are we going to see next, though?
I'm not sure, but hopefully in England again, the rematch.
Right, man, drop me a message, let me know. It'd be good for me to, I don't know if I'll travel down to England, but it'd be good for me to keep up with you, kids. I think, as I said, you and your brothers came here, boxed brilliantly, and definitely I want to see you again. Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
My coaches and a lad who's come down, like, doing the pads for me, Alfie.
Right, my man, listen, thanks so much. Keep your head up, bro. I think you can be proud of that performance. It's not always easy coming up to somebody else's district, and you know what it's like, innit? But well done, bro. And I'll catch you later, yeah? So we are in... Out number 8, Harry Housen from Northwest England, and Max Slough, from Western District. Work out from both boxers. See Harry in the red corner again, very, very comfortable. You can see he's got a lot of confidence as well. Max firing back, trying to get an inside there. Nice straight jabs coming from both boxers. Fenno, 10 seconds around number one. Now this is 3 2-minute rounds. Great round there, I think, for both boxers. I think for me, just the red corner, just slightly edging it, being a bit more accurate. But Max definitely can keep up with the pace. So Max FEBC. I don't think that's your surname, but you're asking how many bouts left. So this is bout number 8. We're going to go for an interval, I think, after this. And then we'll have another 5 after this. So however we look at what we've got. So if you look at the bottom half, just after it says interval bout 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. That'll be coming up next. So Callum McMillan, Henry Richardson, Saif Akram, Malachi Lees, Jack O'Brave, Watson Miller, Josh Hunter, Yusuf Uddin, and Nathan Lewis and Chara Rangeprat.
Jimmy,
So round number two, about number eight on the card. Don't forget, if you are watching, click like and subscribe. Just let us know you're there. Great work there from the red corner. It's now Max Fires back. You see Harry just using that ring speed as well, keeping just slightly back to make it difficult for Max to land. Great technique there from the red corner. Max just needs to take a wee half step forward, but Harry's very, very light in his toes. He knows when to step back very fast as well, just to force his opponent to miss. Another great round there for me. Red corner just slightly edging it. But Max does have the capability. It's just coming up slightly short, just landing from my perspective. But there is judges stationed around the ring that might have a better view than me. Away from those ropes. Harry looks like he's looking for a big finish in this. Peter Vosmich is watching online. Yusuf is here, his big brother. Hamza, he'll be on bout number 12 after the break. Nice shot there, landing. From Max. But Harry continuing to keep this pressure up. He's been relentless throughout. Nice wee sidestep there from the blue corner. He's starting to find his rhythm now. Last 10 seconds of round number three. I will pass straight to Gregory Houston in the ring with the official announcement here for bout number eight on the card.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it for both boxers. After three rounds, the winner on a 4-1 split decision in the blue corner, Max Sleeth. And please, let's hear it for Harry Houston. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a short break from the boxing. Give everyone a chance to get a quick refreshment. And we'll be back shortly with today's second half. Thank you.
So, we're going to pass to an interval now. And we'll be back, possibly about 15, 20 minutes. I'll let you see some of the interviews that we've been doing, I think, from the Dury show. You can have a look at that. We'll be back very, very soon. And while the boxers are making their way to the ring, just come in a wee bit, my man. Brody Dow, kicking off your home show. Did you enjoy that?
Aye, it was brilliant.
You're a great wee boxer, but victory as well. Both of you are really going for it, but I think overall, I need to agree, you did the well. Did this crowd really get behind you?
It was exciting. I liked it. The crowd was amazing as well.
Is it harder to be first up, or would you rather just get it out of the way?
Being first, it's good if you win, but I think sometimes I box better if I'm like third or fourth.
Cool, my man. Who are you looking forward to tonight? Who's your mate sort of boxing?
Ali, it's boxing the news, his first fight.
Oh, wow. That's Muhammad Ali Bhatti.
Aye.
He's up against Orcade and Abanafi. That should be a good bout. So we'll pass back any shout-outs quickly.
I'd like to shout out all the coaches at Blue Vale, Andy, Chris and Kenny. I'd like to shout out my big brother for, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be at Blue Vale. So big shout out to him and shout out to my mum and my dad.
Hey man, I seen they were there waiting for you, so I'll let you go celebrate. Thank you so much for talking to me and I'll catch up with you again shortly. Yeah, let's pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. So we've got a quick minute to speak to Caden. Caden, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling good after that win.
Bro, I think you started to get into your rhythm towards the end of round number one. After that, you were just relentless, man, pushing forward. That was his first Bouncy's debut. How many you own?
Just one, in the Scottish.
That's your second. Amazing, man. Thank you too. You've done well. Jim, we'll see you again.
Aye, obviously. Aye.
That'll be good, mate, to get a wee rematch of that. Quads, both of you got a few bouts under your belt, but you came here. It's not always easy coming to somebody else's home show, but you came here, done the damage. Are we going to see you at the Lanark show at the end of the month?
Probably, yeah. It depends if I find a fight. But
maybe we get a rematch.
Will we?
Well, maybe, I don't know.
I'll be there then.
So we'll be there, we'll be live. So I'm looking forward to that. Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
My mum and my dad over there. Thank you for coming. My brother too for all the help in the garden. Aye, that's it.
Brian Paulus, I'll let you go celebrate, enjoy the night. I'll see you at the end of the month. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. And as they make their way to the ring, joining me live, JTV Live, is Tyler Knox from McTaggart. Scott, how you feeling, my man?
Really good, that's my first win. Just really buzzing that I got the fight and got to win it.
You done amazing, man. I was saying for round one, you're sort of keeping your calm, your composure. I seen Lucas box last week, so I know what he's capable of, but I think you just, as I say, kept that calmness and just looked to execute what you've probably been training in the gym for. So tell us a bit about your training, what you've been practicing.
Well, a lot of just straights and keeping my hands up, but I was doing loads of training trying to get down to the actual weight, trying to get down to it, but it was just a loads of straights and backhands and loads of fitness, because last couple of fights I wasn't as fit.
And what'd you think of Lucas?
He was really good. I sparred him a couple of weeks before that, and he was really good. I really thought when he said 3-2, he was going to give it to him, being his show. But I'm really happy.
That's always in the back of your mind, isn't it? But listen, I thought it did come down to a split decision. But for me, you've done enough to win it consistently throughout the three rounds. Where are we going to see you next?
Don't know. Novices going to win that too.
All right, my man, that'll be up in October, I think the 13th, 14th of October. And anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Just Sandy, and especially Conor Anderson. He helped me the most.
Pose for a picture. There we go, man, I'll let you go celebrate. You can jump down that way, and I'll catch you shortly. Let's pass back to Greg Rusin in the ring. And as bout number five makes her way to the ring, I'm now joined by the winner, bout number four, Jamie Baird. How are you feeling?
Good, brilliant.
Right from the start, man, you were just consistent and just kept going. I kind of thought TJ kind of took his foot off the gas, but you just never. You were just like relentless through it. Yeah. Is that what you've been practicing in the gym?
I've been trying to stay really consistent and put a lot of work in. Just be really busy.
This crowd really got behind you. How much has that helped just get you that edge?
I was kind of focused on my opponent, man. I did try to block the crowd out.
Where are we going to see you next?
Don't know, hopefully soon.
And any shout-outs you've got? I know you've got a few people there supporting you. They couldn't sit in their seat there at the end.
Yeah, I'd like to give a shout-out to all my friends and family and all my coaches at the club and my club that's helped me through to get this.
Right, my man. You've got a few people watching online. I don't know the name. It says Planet Reaper. I don't know who that is, but maybe you know who they are, but they've been supporting you anyway. I'll let you go and celebrate. With your friends and family, my man, Jamie Baird, well done in the win, and I'll catch up with you again shortly, yeah? So, we're joined by Rhys Mackay from Kane Boxing. Rhys, I think well-deserved win, right from the get-go. You just came banging out and then just kept that consistency through it. Was that the game plan?
Not really, I'm not sure.
You just went in and thought, just go?
No, Scott Boone.
What do you think about your opponent?
Yeah, he's good. I fought him before at novices, it was the same band, unanimous decision, but some boy, so
So you just like to go boxing. I was saying that you came boxers, you travel here, there and everywhere. You've obviously came down. Where are we going to see you next?
I'm fighting on the One Art Home Show on the 29th and then novices again. That's it, don't know.
Right, man, you've got a few other cane boxers that are boxing later, innit?
Yeah, Zane Lawson.
Zane Lawson, that'll be a good bout, innit, with Kyle McGregor.
Zane will win it, eh?
So, anybody you want to give a shout out to?
No, really.
All your fans, is a lot of fans we were watching online.
Kane coaches, and then I see Tyler Ross there, I can't him. The fucking.
He's been watching, there we go, Tyler Ross. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe, Tyler. I'll be checking up on that. Listen, man, I'll let you go and celebrate. Thanks so much for talking to me. Well done in the win. It was a great one. Well done. Yeah, let's pass back to Greg Houston in the ring. Where the boxers are making their way to the ring. Just pull your seat in a wee bit, my man. Cruz Kennedy, great matchup between you and Joe from off Glasgow. But you look confident throughout. How are you feeling?
I feel unbelievable, man. Look at it. Look at the atmosphere, it's unbelievable, I'm so happy.
Isn't it? Like, I know you've got a lot of fans here as well. Like, I grabbed you quickly before they had a chance to start pulling you away for hugs and kisses and all. Where are we going to see you next? What's the plan of the year?
Well, we're going to Belfast in October, and then we've got the Scottish, got to win that, and then hopefully the British win that and all.
Right, my man. What did you think of your opponent, Joe?
Joe's a good boxer, you know what I mean? He's a year older, good back foot boxer, but I knew I had to come front through and beat him at his in game, and that's what I done.
Right, anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Yeah, I want to give a shout out to all my coaches, Chris, Andy, Kenny, Ricky, Edgar, everyone and all my, everyone's came out to see me, my gran and all who's in the house. It's good.
Right, my man, listen, I'll let you go celebrate. Great boxing, man, and I'll catch up with you shortly. Yeah, take care. That was Cruz Kennedy. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. Alex, how did you find that? You enjoy it?
Yeah, I loved every second of it. You know, I was starting to get tired in the rounds, but I guess you just got to push, man. That's what you get with boxing. Got to be mentally tough in that. I've got to give it to the other guy. He put in his heart in. Man, I just got to give it to him, man. He was a good boxer. Good boxer.
He's both had your moments in there. It did come down to a split decision. What was going through your mind when you heard that? Because what do you think?
I was a little bit nervous about the split decision, you know, because like he boxed well, yeah. At the first round, I didn't even realize he was a southpaw. That's the problem. So I think like I lost the first round because of that. I don't know if I lost the first round, but like I think like you know, I didn't know who he was. I don't know if he was southpaw or Orthodox. I couldn't tell.
Where we gonna see you next?
When you go see me next, I might ask Andy. You know, shout out to him. I might get him to get me a fight in a week or something. Because you know, I'm trying to get like, 3 fights before the novices. Know what I'm saying?
Right. And anybody want to give a shout out to?
My dad. He's the one that came here. Also, coaches here. Thanks for being there. I also probably shout out to my school. If it wasn't for my school, you know, Lincoln and Blueville, I probably wouldn't even be here boxing. I'd probably be somewhere else. I'd probably be sitting in my room playing games or something, doing nothing with my life, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, stick it to boxing, man. We want to see Mary. That was brilliant. I'll let you go and celebrate. Everybody's gone for a wee interval just now. But listen, thanks for talking to me. Brilliant boxing, and I look forward to seeing you again, my man. Cheers, bro. So, guys, just before we go into the out, Tate Chikenya, Scottish Boxer of the Year as well. Nobody wants to box you now. You have to get exhibitions. What's that about?
I really wanted to fight today, I can't lie, but I'm still grateful to be able to fight someone like him. He's a good boxer, yeah. But yeah.
So Jordan was... Oh, you fucked the mic. Jordan is a tough opponent. It was good that he came in and he got an exhibition in front of your eye. He came in and got in front of your friends and family and all. How's the support been for the crowd?
That's amazing. I just hear them shouting in the Tate, yeah.
And how's the training in the gym going?
Amazing, assuming. I want to shout out to my coaches, Andy, Chris, Kenny, and also to Judge Edgar. Edgar's a good guy.
Yes, man. It was him that put the idea in my head. I didn't know. A few weeks ago, I seen him at the Willie Lemons and Ricky Burns event, and then he was like, oh, you come to Blueville? And I went, I want to come. So last week, a few of your boys were boxing.
That's more than my opinion.
And it's weird because my aunt, two of my aunts just stay like within a few settings for this place. Next year, if you have it here, I'll just stay with one of theirs and stay out for the party.
Yeah, we appreciate you coming here, man. Yeah.
Cheers, man. So anybody else you want to give a shout out to?
My mum, my dad, and everybody that came to support.
Right, man, listen, Tate Chikenya, Love watching you, man, and it'll catch up you very, very shortly. It's passed by Gregory Houston in the ring. And just before we go on to bout number 11, Zane Lawson. Quite a tough bout, but you handled yourself well throughout. Came out by decision in the end, but what's your thoughts?
I thought I did more than enough to win. I thought my movement and pivots in the first round won me the first, and then after that, it started getting a bit more scrappy. But I thought I definitely won it. But I know he's just coming off his silver GBs at the GBs, so I knew that'd be a really good scrap. I knew it'd be a really hard fight.
Quite earlier on in the first round, I was seeing big shots landing. You were throwing them, and like I could feel them even away back here. But a great box I watch. I think that's probably my favourite bout of the night, because the two of you just sort of gave it your all. But where are we going to see you next?
I'm hoping to do intermediates, do the opens next year, get gold at both of those, and try out for the British team. As soon as I get onto that British team, gonna keep progressing, only gonna get better. So that's what I'm hoping to do this season.
Right, my man, any shout outs you want to give?
I know Tyler Ross is, I heard you on the stream earlier. Yeah, Tyler, big man.
Right, my man. Right. I know you've got a lot to travel, man, so yeah. Safe journey back, and I'll catch up with you shortly, man. Brilliant boxing, see you later. That was Zane Lawson. And just as they'll make their way to the ring, Aaron, great performance, man. What's your thoughts on it?
Yeah, it was a good fight. That guy was quite tough, just short notice as well. Found out on the Tuesday, I had to cut loads of weight, but quite happy with the performance.
What about your opponent? What's your thoughts on and Kyle? What's your thoughts?
Oh, he's got his son lad, quite strong, always came forward, so quite tricky, but so.
It's a good, enjoyable bout to watch, man. I think you two, you've really put each other through your paces and really like test yourself, but I agree completely with the decision. I think you've done more than enough to get the three rounds to win. Where are we going to see you next?
Oh, I don't know. Just whenever Terry gets a fight, really, that's it.
And anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Mum and Dad. They moaned last time I never gave them one, so.
But man, I'll let you go, sir, mate. Thanks for talking to me. Well done in the win. Passed by Gregory Houston in the ring. Hercules, my man. You getting paid by the minute or something? Well, you guys?
To do this, I've been wanting to do this for so long.
With the interview or the interview? Is that why you ended it so fast?
This is why I just, you know, I was like.
What's your thoughts? I know you're barely had it.
I was coming here to, you know, I was coming here to win. I wasn't coming here to play. I've been training so hard since my last fight at the Wheeling Ballers. This new season, I'm coming for everyone, you know.
Do right, my man. You've got a lot of support in the audience. They were taking the roof off the place. What does that mean to have that support?
I couldn't imagine that. I was. I don't know what to say, man.
It's overwhelming, man. It's overwhelming.
It's a good feeling.
And you said you're coming for everybody, but where are we going to see you next?
I am coming for the novices. I need to get in the bag, you know. I'll be fighting at 6-7. Yes, I can't
wait. So be warned, everybody.
Yeah, I can't wait. You know, everyone should, you know, listen. I'm coming for the 6-7 guys. Better be ready for the novices.
Who do you like to give a shout out to?
I want to give a shout out to my club, Blueville. I want to give a shout out to Coach Kenny. Coach Andy, he's not here. And Chris, he's been a really good help, good support for me, you know. All the coaches. Big Stevie. Big shout out to the Blueville team. Love it, enjoyed it, good show.
Oh, my man, let's all go celebrate.
Thanks
so much, I look forward to seeing you during the rear.
Thank you, sir.
Take care, pal. That was Hercules Camden. Johnny B ringside. Suhaib and Abe. That's definitely the bout of the night so far. Absolute belter. The two of you really put everything into it. What's your thoughts?
I wasn't throwing my jab enough. I know that, man. My left arm was getting the hot, but it was all right. But I just didn't throw my jab enough. And I felt like if I threw a jab more, I would have won that easier. But obviously another. And that's what I'm just learning at the end of the day, you know what I mean?
It seemed that towards the end, the sort of stamina was sort of reducing that. You'd sort of just upped your game, just kept at that level consistently. Is that what you were finding in the ring?
Second round, I felt his stamina dropped. I tried to tell at the body mill, but then I think he clicked onto it and started blocking mill. But it was a good fight, aye.
Are we going to see that again?
Hopefully, man. Aye.
It was brilliant, man. Everybody was gone. My senior brother in it as well. Like, Jakey gets nervous watching you.
I don't know. A wee bit.
How were you when you watch him?
A wee bit nervous. I can't lie.
Any shout-outs you want to give?
Aye, my coach at Blue Vale, Chris, Andy, Kenny, Edgar, Ricky and all that. Aye.
Boy, my man. Listen, I'll let you go celebrate. Brilliant performance, man. Can't wait to see you again. Don't leave it too long either. Do I wait too long, my man? Thank you, bro. Take care of you. So, guys, just before we go, I hope you've enjoyed the night. We've got comments coming in. Cormac Wallace, you know who that is? So, Aidy Turnup, main event in Bluevale's home show. It's not always easy coming to somebody else's home show, main eventing, but after that, about, and it was a 4-1 split at the end, but I think the two of you done amazing, and I can't agree, like, you, for me, you're more consistent throughout. How you feeling?
Fucked, man. I'm down, so I'm not swearing, but, nah, mate, it's my first fight back in like a year and a half, man. I was way up at uni and that, but I feel class, man. I just want to keep getting in there and keep fighting.
So, right, man, I know Mark will be taking you here, there and everywhere. So don't leave it too long before we see you. But how's it been in the gym, getting back into it, training?
Oh, class. I mean, it's so good. I mean, we've got so many top boys there to spar with, and we all push each other on, and it's just such a good atmosphere in the gym, man, and even they're all up here supporting the night. And
Dumfries is a hefty boxing city.
Oh, isn't it?
Right, and I remember when I came down for your show last year, it was like, people were talking about it, it was like, and I suppose that was your first show last year in 14 years. I know you've got another one. It's going to be coming up when the books gets confirmed. But the support you get locally, as well as fans that are even travelling, I know you get some of your boys with you. What does that mean for you?
Oh, it's everything. I mean, it's class just having all the boys here with Mark and that. Mark does so much to drive us up and down everywhere to sparring and that, and it's just class. I mean, they kind of spurred me on tonight, you know. It's just so good.
Grassroots boxer. Just squeeze up, we'll manage.
One of the grassroots boxer. This boy started with Nith Valley, hadn't he put a pair of gloves on, and he's been out for a couple of years. Thought he'd be a wee bit rusty, but in the other night he done brilliant. That's top of the bill.
Yeah, brilliant, top man.
Top lad.
So where are we going to see you next?
Just as soon as possible, hopefully.
You have you on Sunday. get a rest, get back in the gym. Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Yeah, my mum, my dad, Daniel, Cormac, Jack, Lewis, just, I don't know, man. I'm Mark, the goat, Mark and Scott, just everyone.
Right, my listen, Aidan, brilliant to see you back. As I say, don't leave it too long to be see you again. Thanks so much, Mark. As always, catch up with you shortly, yeah? Cheers. And while the boxers are making their way to the ring, just come in a wee bit, my man. Brody Dow, kicking off your home show. Did you enjoy that?
Aye, it was brilliant.
You're a great wee boxer, but Victor as well, both of you are really going for it, but I think overall, I need to agree, you did well. Did this crowd really get behind you?
It was exciting. I liked it. The crowd was amazing as well.
Is it harder to be first up, or would you rather just get it out of the way?
Being first, it's good if you win, but I think sometimes I box better if I'm like third or fourth.
Cool, my man. Who are you looking forward to tonight? Who's your mates that are boxing?
Ali, that's boxing, I know. It's his first fight.
Oh, wow. That's Muhammad Ali Bhatti.
Aye.
He's up against Orcade and Abernathy. Should be a good bout. So we'll pass back any shout-outs quickly.
I'd like to shout out all the coaches at Blue Vale, Andy, Chris and Kenny. I'd like to shout out my big brother for, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be at Blueville, so big shout out to him, and shout out to my mum and my dad.
Right, man, I seen they were there waiting for you, so I'll let you go celebrate. Thank you so much for talking to me, and I'll catch up with you again shortly, yeah? Let's pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. So we've got a quick minute to speak to Caden. Caden, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling good after that win.
Bro, I think you started getting into your rhythm towards the end of round number one. After that, you're just relentless, man, pushing forward. That was his first Bouncy's debut. How many are you on?
Just one in the Scottish.
That's your second one. Aye. Bro, that was you're doing amazing, man. Thank you too, you've done well. Jim, we'll see you again.
Aye, obviously. Aye.
That'll be good, mate, to get a wee rematch of that, because both of you have got a few bouts under your belt, but you came here. It's not always easy coming to somebody else's home show, but you came here, done the damage. Are we going to see you at the Lanark show at the end of the month?
Probably, yeah. It depends if we find a fight. But
maybe we get a rematch.
Will we?
Maybe, I don't know.
I'll be there then.
So we'll be there, we'll be live. So I'm looking forward to that. Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
My mum and my dad over there. Thank you for coming. My brother too for all the help in the garden. Aye, that's it.
Brilliant, pal. Listen, I'll let you go celebrate. Enjoy night. I'll see you at the end of the month. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. And as they make their way to the ring, joining me live, JTV Live, is Tyler Knox from McTaggart. Scott, how you feeling, my man?
Really good. That's my first win. Just really buzzing that I got the fight and got to win it.
I think you've done amazing, man. I think you I was saying for round one, you're sort of keeping your calm, your composure. I seen Lucas box last week, so I know what he's capable of, but I think you just, as I say, kept that calmness and just looked to execute what you've probably been training in the gym for. So tell us a bit about your training, what you've been practicing.
Well, a lot of just straights and keeping my hands up, but I was doing loads of training trying to get down to the actual weight, trying to get down to it, but it was just a loads of straights and backhands and loads of fitness, because last couple of fights I wasn't as fit.
And what did you think of Lucas?
He was really good. I sparred him a couple of weeks before that, and he was really good. I really thought when he said 3-2 he was going to give it to him, being his show, but I'm really happy I got it.
That's always in the back of your mind, isn't it? But listen, I thought it did come down to a split decision, but for me, you've done enough to win it consistently throughout the three rounds. Where are we going to see you next?
Don't know. Novices going to win that too.
All right, my man, that'll be up in October, I think the 13th, 14th of October. And anybody you want to give a shout out to?
Just Sandy, and especially Conor Anderson. He helped me the most.
Always for a picture. There we go, man, I'll let you go celebrate. You can jump down that way, and I'll catch you shortly. Let's pass back to Greg Rusin in the ring. And as bout number five makes her way to the ring, I'm now joined by the winner, bout number four, Jamie Baird. How you feeling?
Good, brilliant.
Right from the start, man, you were just consistent and just kept going. I kind of thought TJ kind of took his foot off the gas, but you just never. You were just like relentless through it. Yeah. Is that what you've been practicing in the gym?
I've been trying to stay really consistent and put a lot of work in. Just be really busy.
This crowd really got behind you. How much has that helped just get you that edge?
I was kind of focused on my opponent, man. I did try to block the crowd out.
Where are we going to see you next?
Don't know, hopefully soon.
And any shout outs you want to go? I know you got a few people there supporting you. They couldn't sit in their seat there at the end.
Yeah, I would like to give a shout out to all my friends and family and all my coaches at the club and my club that's helped me through to get this.
Right, my man. You got a few people watching online. I don't know the name, it says Planet Reaper. I don't know who that is, but maybe you know who they are, but they've been supporting you anyway. I'll let you go and celebrate. With your friends and family, my man, Jamie Baird, well done in the win, and I'll catch up with you again shortly, yeah? So, we're joined by Rhys Mackay from Kane Boxing. Rhys, I think well-deserved win, right for the get-go. You just came banging out and then just kept that consistency through it. Was that the game plan?
Not really, I'm not sure.
You just went in and thought, just go?
No, Scott Wayne.
What do you think about your opponent?
Yeah, he's good. I fought him before at Novices, It was the same band, unanimous decision, but some boy, so
you just like to go boxing. I was saying that you came boxers, you travel here, there and everywhere. You've obviously came down. Where are we going to see you next?
I'm fighting on the One Art Home Show on the 29th and then Novices again. But that's it, don't know.
Right, man, you've got a few other Kane boxers that are boxing later, innit?
Zane Lawson.
Zane Lawson, that'll be a good bout, innit, with Kyle McGregor.
Zane will win it.
So, anybody want to give a shout out to?
No, really.
Oh, your fans, there's a lot of fans we're watching online.
Kane coaches, and then I see Tyler Ross there, I can't him.
He's been watching, there we go, Tyler Ross. Thanks for watching, don't forget to click like and subscribe, Tyler. I'll be checking up on that. Listen, man, I'll let you go and celebrate. Thanks so much for talking to me. Well done in the win. It was a great one. Well done, yeah. Let's pass back to Greg Rusin in the ring. Well, the boxers are making their way to the ring. Just pull your seat in a wee bit, my man. Cruz Kennedy, great matchup between you and Joe from North Glasgow. But you look confident throughout. How are you feeling?
I feel unbelievable, man. It's just look at it.
Look, the atmosphere, it's unbelievable. I'm so happy.
Isn't it? Like, I know you've got a lot of fans here as well. Like, I grabbed you quickly before they had a chance to start pulling you away for hugs and kisses and all. Where are we going to see you next? What's the plan of the year?
Well, we're going to Belfast in October, and then we've got the Scottish, got to win that, and then hopefully the British win that and all.
Right, my man. What did you think of your opponent, Joe?
Joe's a good boxer, you know what I mean? He's a year older, good back foot boxer, but I knew I had to come front foot and beat him at his in game, and that's what I done.
Right, anybody want to give a shout out to?
Yeah, I want to give a shout out to all my coaches, Chris, Andy, Kenny, Ricky, Edgar, everyone in all my, everyone's came out to see me, my gran and all who's in the house. It's good.
Right, my man, listen, I'll let you go celebrate. Great boxing, man. And I'll catch up with you shortly. Yeah, take care. That was Cruz Kennedy. We'll pass back to Gregory Houston in the ring. Alex, how did you find that? You enjoy it?
Yeah, I loved every second of it. You know, I was starting to get tired in the rounds, but I guess like, you just got to push, man. That's what you get with boxing. Got to be mentally tough in that. I've got to give it to the other guy. He put in his heart in. Man, I just got to give it to him, man. He was a good boxer. Good boxer.
He's both had your moments in there. It did come down to a split decision. What was going through your mind when you heard that? Because what do you think?
I was a little bit nervous about the split decision, you know. Because, like, he boxed well, yeah. At the first round, I didn't even realise he was a southpaw. That's the problem. So I think, like, I lost the first round because of that. I don't know if I lost the first round, but, like, I think, like, you know, I didn't know who he was. I don't know if he was southpaw or Redux. I couldn't tell.
Where are we going to see you next?
When you go see me next, I might ask Andy, you know, shout out to him. I might get him to give me a fight in a week or something. Because, you know, I'm trying to get like, 3 fights before the novices. You know what I'm saying?
Right, and anybody want to give a shout out to?
My dad. He's the one that came here. Also, coaches here. Thanks for being there. I also probably shout out to my school. If it wasn't for my school, you know, Lincoln with Bluefield, I probably wouldn't even be here boxing. I'd probably be somewhere else. I'd probably be sitting in my room playing games or something, doing nothing with my life, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, stick it to boxing, man. We want to see Mary. That was brilliant. I'll let you go and celebrate. Everybody's gone for a wee interval. Just now. But listen, thanks for talking to me. Brilliant boxing. And I look forward to seeing you again, my man. Cheers, bro. So, guys, just before we go into that bout, to Kenya, Scottish Boxer of the Year as well. Nobody wants to box you now. You have to get exhibitions. What's that about?
I really wanted to fight today. I can't lie, but I'm still grateful to be able to fight someone like him. He's a good boxer, yeah. But
So Jordan was... Oh, you fucked the mic. Jordan is a tough opponent. It was good that he came in. He got an exhibition in front of your eye. He came in and got it in front of your friends and family and all. How's the support been for the crowd?
That's amazing. I just hear them shouting in the tee, yeah.
And how's the training in the gym going?
Amazing, assuming. I want to shout out to my coaches, Andy, Chris, Kenny, and also to Judge Edgar. Edgar's a good guy.
Yes, man. It was him that put the idea in my head. I didn't know. A few weeks ago, I seen him at the Willie Lemons and Ricky Burns event, and then he was like, oh, you come to Blueville? And I went, I want to come. So last week, a few of your boys were boxing.
That's more than my opinion.
And it's weird because two of my aunts just stay like within a few settings for this place. Next year, if you have it here, I'll just stay with one of theirs and stay out for the party.
Yeah, we appreciate you coming here, man. Yeah.
So anybody else you want to give a shout out to?
My mom, my dad, and everybody that came to support.
Right, man, listen, take you, Kenya. I love watching you, man, and I'll catch up with you very, very shortly. Let's pass by Gregory Houston in the ring. And just before we go on to bout number 11, Zane Lawson. Quite a tough bout, but you handled yourself well throughout. Can you
So guys, welcome back to the Western District of Scotland versus the North West of England. Gregory Houston is in the ring. The officials are just taking their seats at ringside. And you're watching JATV Live's coverage live on our YouTube channel.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to get underway now with the second half of today's boxing. Would you please welcome the boxers to the ring?
Your cause is the dust, the sands of the rise.
do I? Does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like...
Ladies and gentlemen, we begin the second half today with a junior contest at light welterweight. Over 3 2-minute rounds, referee is Mr. John McKenna. Introducing first, boxing out of the red corner, wearing blue shorts with white, representing Northwest England, Henry Richardson. And in the blue corner, wearing the blue shorts with grey tartan, representing Scotland's Western District, Callum Miller. 3 2-minute rounds.
Come on.
Sorry, so I was just covering for the young people to take a break. He operates for cameras. He's back. So I'm back. So this is bout number 9, Callum McMillan from the Western District of Scotland and Henry Richardson. We've got another 4 bouts after this. So should be done about just after 3 o'clock, what I was asking. So Kian Leo, oh no, it is Charlie. I just seen your cover online. So Callum is Antonine Boxing in blue. He's representing the Western District of Scotland today. Few seconds around number 3, and we'll have a winner for you. Both these boxers have tried the best to remain in it to the very end, and that's the bell. We will pass to Gregory Houston in the ring with an official announcement. Don't go anywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, please let's hear it for both boxers! After 3 rounds, the winner by unanimous decision in the blue corner, Callum McMillan! And please let's hear it for Henry Richardson!
And we've just got time to speak to Callum before the next bout comes. Callum, I spoke to you earlier, you said you're a bit nervous. I was wondering if it was for the bout or the interview. But you got through the bout. How'd you find it?
It was tough. He's a good opponent for somebody that's had no fights. So it was good experience. Shows me what I need to improve on.
Yeah, I think it's a good learning experience as well. I mean, you did get a unanimous decision, but he was a tough opponent. But I know you travel around, like the whole Antonine team supports each other, but you go, I've seen you up in Glenrothes as well, you all go outside in the Western District to find bouts. So it's good that they've come up here and you've got a chance to test yourself as well. Where are we going to see you next?
Barrhead, October 7th, and then in Novices.
Well, man, look forward to a busy year.
Aye.
Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
My brother, his girlfriend, my dad over there. My mum and all my family watching at home. My girlfriend as well. So that's it.
Right, my man, go home and rest. And I'm sure, I know I'm going to see you soon because I see your body everywhere. But cheers for talking to me. We'll pass to Gregory Houston in the ring. For about number 10, Saif Akram and Malachi Lees.
The referee is Mr. Paul O'Connor. Introducing first, boxing out of the red corner with red, representing North West England, Malachi Lees. And in the blue corner, wearing black shorts with gold, representing Scotland's Western District, Seth Akram. 3 2-minute rounds.
So this is 3 2-minute rounds. Saif Akram from the Western District in the blue corner and Malachi Lees from North West England in the red, 61kg junior. We're just saying to Archie Dury there, for Dury's Boxing Club, how much Saif has grown over the years. He's no taller than his both. Oh, nice shots are landing from Seth. Malachi looking to respond to that in kind. Nice head movement there from Seth as he moves in, just using his shoulder to block. But Malachi's throwing. He just needs to watch. He's keeping that guard up. He's doing it nicely, but when he's nice shot there landing from Seth, left followed by the right. There we go again. Very impressed with Seth. As I said, I've known him for years. We knew boxing out of Rob Roy Boxing Club. And he's quiet outside the ring, but just does the business inside. As he's improved a lot the last few years. So he goes a nice start to this bout. I think for me, Seth's done enough to take the points on that one. But Malachi, definitely a tough opponent. He knows what he's doing in there. We'll see what happens, as we always do in the next rounds. So guys, you're watching JATV Live's coverage of the Western District of Scotland versus North West of England here at Antonine Boxing Club. And Dalmuir, just outside of Clydebank in Glasgow, close to where I live, for about 30 minutes. I think it was 20 minutes in the train. Not too far out from the west of the border, the west of Glasgow. Let's go back in the ring. So we got the round number 2, Saif Akram in the blue corner. And Malachi Lees in the red. Both boxers come out fast. Yeah. himself as the younger cousin of Boxing Scotland's internationalist Issa Akram, who's in the audience, just passed his driving test, so congratulations on that. Walk again from Seth from that left and right. Malachi just slightly taking his foot off the gas. But Malachi is landing some shots, but I just think Seth's being the busier. And he, thing with Seth, he's not scared to take a shot, and he's responding with two or three of his own. Sometimes you see a lot of boxers hold back, but he's not that type of boxer. He's taking nice with step backs as well, responding there, three nice shots, at least two of them landed. Referee just having to remind Seth not to hold. Last 10 seconds of round number two. Well done again to both boxers. I think for me, Seth's done enough. Know that Malachi hasn't been as busy, but just accuracy is just not quite there. He's maybe landing one compared to Seth landing two or three combinations at a time. So let me know what your thoughts are. No bias either, I'm trying not to be biased. Some of your thoughts online. Don't forget, click like and subscribe. You can watch all this back later on JTV Live. And if you want to buy any individual bouts, they're £35, and we'll edit that and post that for you. So drop me a message either on JTV Live social medias, Instagram, or you can email us, jamie@jtvlive.com. Also, if you're wanting to support JTV Live, JTV Goals, our youth mentoring charity, details are up on the screen. Let's pass back in the ring. Third and final round of bout number 10 on the card. Save Akram versus Malachi Lees. I think for me, Malachi needs this round to have any consideration by the judges for the win. Save just needs to watch. He's been warned twice in the last round about holding. It is getting a bit tangled at times, but he's doing well to stay on the back foot, use that ring space and draw his opponent in. Nice left and right now landing from Malachi, starting to find some sort of rhythm. Big shot there landing from each, but Malachi looks as he gave a big shot there, a big right landing and Seth. As I said, Seth isn't scared to take a shot or two. He just needs to watch what's coming towards him. Issa Akram in the crowd there giving Seth some advice, saying keep your hands up, move your head. I think I need to echo that advice as well. Malachi resorting to a big left body shot there. Big left there landing, almost hits the referee. Malachi really going for it in this round. Seth, nice head movement there. We need to see more of that. Final 10 seconds of round number three. And well done to both boxers passing Gregory Houston. Just before we do, well done to both. I think Malachi starting to find his feet towards the end that bout. But in my estimation, Seth's done enough. We'll find out what the judges think in just a second.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it for both boxers. After three rounds, the winner by unanimous decision in the blue corner, Sev Akram. And please, let's hear it for Malachi Lees.
So just before we go into the next bout, Sev Akram is joining me now ringside. Sev, brilliant performance. I was saying that I've seen you since you were young. I say to Archie as well, you're no taller than both of us. You came out, you're not scared to sort of take your hat, but you're responding with a combination. That's where I think you're constantly picking up the points. Is that what you've been working on in the gym?
I think, yeah, I was like just working on countering instead of just like being the first one. And my stamina at that last round, a bit tired.
I've seen that, man. But what you done in the first two rounds, I did say going into the third, I thought I had you two rounds up. Then the third round, I think I did see your stamina sort of going. He started to find a bit of rhythm. But I think the first two rounds he couldn't match you. I think you just came out and just performed amazingly. Where are we going to see you next one, man?
Maybe another home show in about 2-3 weeks.
So. You'll let me know, man, because I might, there's some home shows I've got coming up, but even if I'm not, if I'm in the area, I'll drop by. How's Rob Roy doing? He's all right up there?
Yeah, it's good. Good sparring. Adam Marfan, he's my like number one sparring partner, so it's quite good.
So you had your cousins in the audience as well?
Isak Akram. He came over to support me. My wee brother, Ibrahim. And Ayan.
So they were shouting support. Anybody you want to give a shout out to before you go?
Just my coaches, Tiger, Davey and Kevin. And my family for coming down and watching.
Well, my man, that's how you go celebrate. Well done. I can't wait to see you again, my man. Okay, yeah.
And in the blue corner, wearing black shorts with white, representing Scotland's Western District, Jack Galbraith! 3 2-minute rounds.
So all these interviews will be posted later on today on JTV Live's Instagram and YouTube channel. We're in bout number 11, Jack Galbraith from Western District and Watson Miller from North West England. Reduce the size of the stream going out. There's a wee bit of buffering issue there. Hopefully we sort that out. Three bouts left after this, two bouts, sorry, we've got Josh Hunter and Yusuf Uddin and Nathan Lewis and Chad Wonsprat. We're on bout number 11. Jack Galbraith and Watson Miller. This is 3 2-minute round, 65 kg junior. Middle 10 seconds of round number one.
Big swings are landing just at the end there for Jack Gilbrave, the Auckland Geek boxer. So you're watching JATV Live's coverage of the Western District of Scotland versus North West England with me, Jamie Alexander O'Neill. You can watch all this back on our YouTube channel. Individual bouts can be ordered and edited for £35. Just head to our website, jatvlive.com. Yep, we've got a question coming up from Ricky Sohal. How you doing? Yeah, Yusuf is on next. Yusuf Uddin from Northwest England will be boxing Josh Hunter from the Western District. Meanwhile, bout number 11, round number 2. Jack Gilbrave from Auckland Geek representing the Western District, and Watson Miller from the Northwest of England. Great work there from Watson. Jack looking for a big swing there. They're followed up by a few lefts in the middle. Watson sticking to those straight jabs. Straight jabs are key. Just continuing to throw that left, the boy in red. Using that ring space well, being reminded just to watch. He's punching with his gloves, not slapping with his wrist. Final 10 seconds of round number 2. Quite an even round for me. Red corner taking that one. I just seen more straight jabs down the middle. Jack thrown with the left, but then falling up with a big swing in the right. By the time it hits his opponent's seen it coming. I'm just going to cut away with setting. So we're calling it just the red corner. We were just sick there, which means this match will be called off. Going into the third round. We'll pass to Gregory Houston in the ring with the official announcement. Just bear with us a wee second.
ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it for both boxers. At the beginning of round number two, the referee calls a stop to the bout on the advice of the ringside doctor. The winner by RSC in the blue corner, Jack Albury! And ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it for Watson Miller!
So we've got about 5 minutes to kill before the next bout. Jack Galbraith, I'm sure you were looking forward to going out to the third round there, but did you enjoy it?
I knew what I was going for, man. I seen that body shot hitting. The ref braked it and I just knew what to do, you know what I mean? Went for the body and that's what I wanted to do, man. Got the stop.
So obviously it did get stopped going into the third round in advice to the doctor. I think he was sick. There happens in it, but you think that was for that big punch?
That body shot, I know. That was that body shot, man. Hit me a good few. I just kept going. The ref broke, as you seen at the end of that round, man. Right back on him, man. I know that was my plan for the third round. That body.
So, where are we going to see you next one, man?
Whenever, man. Whenever I get a fight, I'll take it, man.
Are you finding it difficult to get matched up, or easy, or what? You just
no, it's Joe and Chris, all the coaches there. They're brilliant, man. They get me matched. Sort it for me, man. It's all the coaches.
Who do I give a shout out to?
All the boys in Moody's Burn, man. All the boys at home watching this fight. Anybody watching this fight, shout out to all yous.
My man, listen, I'll let you go and cool down and celebrate. Cheers for speaking to me. That was Jack Galbraith winning bout number 11. So, as I said, we've got a few minutes before the next bout. So, we'll probably cut to an advert. Don't go anywhere, we'll be back as soon as you're watching JATV Live's coverage of the Western District of Scotland versus North West England here at Antonine Boxing Club, sponsored by Kelvinside Motor Company. Up next, we'll have Josh Hunter versus Yusuf Uddin. That should be a decent one for you guys to watch at home. Don't go anywhere.
guys, welcome back. We're ready to go without number 12, Josh Hunter versus Yusuf Uddin. Guys, you're watching JATV Live's coverage of the Western District of Scotland versus North West England. We had a great afternoon here at boxing at the Antonine Boxing Club, Antonine Boxing Club in Dalmuir, just outside Clybank and Glasgow. 2 bouts left, this one and then the next. So guys, joining me at ringside, introduce yourself.
I'm Blossom Weir and my pal's
from
fighting
Dunhamers.
Next from Dunhamers.
So your teammate for Dunhamers. So we'll let Greg introduce them and then we'll be back in just a second.
Over 3 3-minute rounds, the referee is Mr. George Brown. Introducing first, boxing out of the red corner, wearing black shorts with gold, representing North West England, Yusuf Uddin. And in the blue corner, wearing white shorts with blue tartan, representing Scotland's Western District, Josh Hunter. 3 3-minute rounds.
To go round number one. Josh Hunter, the Dunhamers boxer in the blue corner, representing the Western District. He's watching Yusuf Uddin. So Blossom, you know Josh well, innit? You travelled here to support him. Is he in the gym as much as you?
Aye, 3 times a week.
What's he been like the day preparing for this?
Oh, he's been good. He was just nervous because it was on like second last.
Yeah, it's a long wait, isn't it?
Long wait.
So we're just saying that Yusuf Uddin, younger brother, Hamza Uddin.
Yeah.
Gold medalist.
Like,
yeah.
I saw on his face.
Yeah, he's in his corner.
That last point was the boy a bit sick.
Yeah, he took a body shot and then after that he dropped. So that he nice swap girl from the red corner. We can see that Josh is in that ring space well. He doesn't want to get caught up against the ropes.
No. He likes to hit and be away. But this is a bigger challenge for him, English boy.
You can
but
just
that's who he has to fight.
Yeah. You can see Yusuf's very, very comfortable in the ring as well, isn't it? You see this focus in their eyes.
Your hands up, Joe.
Nice spot there again from the red corner, leading with those. So if no gain, Josh, much space. Josh just find it difficult to break through. I think Yusuf just has that longer reach as well.
He just pings out the 2 straights, I just get some.
Been a few seconds around number one.
Yeah,
first 3 minute run.
So this is it free freeze?
It's free freeze. Have they changed that? Or is it free freeze?
I don't know.
Sure.
It says free freeze on the card. So this is free 3 minute rounds, 46 kg. But I'd heard there was only one free freeze, so I don't know if we need to count and see if that was 2 minutes or 3 minutes. Cameraman, playing his music. So, what's your thoughts?
I think Josh just needs to throw a bit more punches because he just throws the one shot.
That's hard, man. You can see Yusuf just very comfortable.
He's very
in there.
Very comfortable.
He's got this little laser sharp focus. Yeah. He just like whatever Josh is going. I mean,
and
the corner is telling Josh to go first, but sometimes I think it's difficult if he does that because then Yusuf's got to retaliate. Yeah. He's the sort of ready to go in any situation. We would go round number two. Yusuf Uddin in the red corner from northwest of England and Josh Hunter in the blue. Josh just upped the tempo a wee bit. But Yusuf just showing he can work as effective in the back foot as he can in the front. It's a big challenge for Josh, as you said, and good for him for taking. There's a few pullouts earlier, but Josh knew who he was getting in the ring with, and still went for it. But you doing Hamer's boxers, I like that, innit? He's like a tough challenge.
Just taking in the comfort, so I mean, he doesn't get many fights anyways, so when you get one, you just have to go for it.
Good use of the left jab there, and then straight away he raised his right just to anticipate what was coming towards him. So he is learning, he's trying to adapt in there. But Yusuf as well is
just an amazing fighter.
He's just brilliant to watch.
Yeah.
Straight left, right side coming from Yusuf in the red again. He's really setting the pace.
Oh, Josh.
Yeah, I was just saying that, like, Yusuf's kept this pace throughout, and it's not easy to keep up with that. But he is trying, that's the thing, he's not sort of gave up. Being a big right there. I know, 10 seconds of round number two.
Well, keep going, Josh. Oh, nice.
Well, it's another tough round there to watch. Yusuf just really setting that pace, not easing up at all. But we said, Josh, it's a tough opponent. He is trying. I mean, he's not gave up. He's still trying to find some wins there. But I'm guessing Yusuf being with a part of the Uddin squad, very well trained, used to the ring. Got one more round left of bout number 12, and then I'll just show you the card. Last up,
Nathan Lewis,
and Chara Runge Pratt, hope I'm pronouncing that right.
I'm sure Dave Ben, alright?
It's alright,
I like
afternoon shows.
Yeah.
But I've had a busy weekend. I've not stopped. This is the third event I've had this weekend.
You had the Blue Vale show, didn't you?
At Blue Vale, St Andrews on Thursday. So go round number three. Josh now try to lean, go on with that left. But Udin switching up sometimes to the bodies, combinations are brutal. I mean, he is finding some success, Josh. He is like finding these wee pockets opportunity. And we've not had any counts. It just shows you how tough he is. Guards came loose of just finding shots here, there and everywhere, changing it up when he needs to. Getting a bit tangled up here and there. As I said, he's kept in it. He's still trying. He has found wee pockets of success, yeah. But I think Yusuf Udin is just phenomenal, man. It's a word we use up here with Iron Brew. Phenomenal. Better 10 seconds of round number three.
Well done, that's it.
Well done to both boxers there. Dalmuir, thank you for talking to me. I'll let you go. We'll pass to Gregory Houston in the ring with the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, please let's hear it for both boxers. After three rounds, the winner by unanimous decision in the red corner, Yusuf Udin. And please, let's hear it for Josh Hunter. Western District, who's put this together today with some great matchmaking, a great event here at the start of the season. A big thank you as well to our friends from Northwest of England coming up and helping give us.
And well, Greg, just as a thank you, Yusuf Udin, absolute brilliant performance, complete masterclass, brilliant to watch. How did you find it?
Alhamdulillah. First off, I want to thank Allah for that victory. Thanks to my coaches as well, who took me all the way to Scotland from Birmingham. It's a 5 or 6 hours. And also I want to say fair play to the coach and fair play to the kid who took the fight, because obviously I couldn't get any fights in England.
We were saying that I had one of his teammates with me, and we were saying that he sometimes struggles to get fights as well, so he needs to sort of step up. This was a big challenge for him. In fairness to him, he was still trying in the third round, but I think for the third round it was just, as I said, a masterclass of boxing. Must run in the family as well. You've got, I know you've got your brother here supporting you, your corner. Where are we going to see you next this year?
In about 2 months' time, I'm going to be entering Nationals, which called NABCs. Inshallah, I'll win that. And I think I'm ready for it.
Keep racking up these goals.
Thank you.
Anybody you want to give a shout out to?
I want to give a shout out to my dad and my brother Hamza, and also my family as well, because my mum's at home. She's praying for me. She's not just my mum, the whole family as well. They're crying for me as well. But alhamdulillah, we got the victory we needed. Also, I haven't fought in months as well, so yeah.
So you saved it all up and came and put on that masterclass for us, bro. Thanks so much for talking to me. Hudafus, and I'll see you again shortly.
Thank you.
So that was Yusuf Uddin. We've got one more bit left. We'll pass to Gregory Houston in the ring.
And when the bell rings, our referee in charge is Mr. Paul O'Connor. Introducing first, boxing in the red corner, wearing blue shorts with white, representing Northwest England, Tara Winkler. And in the blue corner, wearing blue shorts with white trim, representing Scotland's Western District, Nathan Lewis. 3 2-minute round.
This is 3 2-minute rounds. It does say 3-3 on the card. Three 2-minute rounds. Nathan Lewis, Chara, Roy Pratt. Quick start. But I know both very, very capable boxers. Nathan Lewis of Vine Brock. This is the last bout of this afternoon. Thank you so much for everyone that's been tuning in and watching, everyone that's been watching back. Nice work there from Nathan, landing big left and right, switching from body to head. Great work again, very, very capable boxer. Says gets his gloves up and awaits what's coming back, making it difficult for his opponent to land and pick up points. Nathan has Alex Mullen, a senior in his corner, very, very respected coach up here in Scotland. Final 10 seconds to round number one, as Chara tries to stay in it as well. He's matching the pace, but just not finding as much success as Nathan. Wow, absolute belter of our first round there, about number 13. So joining me at ringside, Lucas Ewan from Dury's Boxing Club. I mean, you were boxing last week, so it's no long ago I spoke to you. How are you feeling?
Good, mate.
Have you came back down to earth after that?
Aye, definitely,
one?
Man.
How are you enjoying the day?
It's brilliant, man. Brilliant fights, great matches.
Do you see that Yusuf Uddin in the last?
This is
the main event. It's definitely living up to being the main event. So we go round number two. You know Nathan?
I know Nathan, man.
Your mates with Oscar Stephen, it is boxes at his gym as well.
It's a good fight, definitely.
Nathan's very sharp and very fast in it.
He's got to be busy with that jab.
Red Corner did come out with a lot of confidence, I thought. I seen him in the back as well. He's very, just been listening to his music, focusing on the fight. I say fight, I need to say bout, I'm not allowed to say fight. You can say it. But here we go, even the Red Corner picking up some points now, but
you've got to keep it long and straight.
You see how he gets his gloves up, trying to make it harder for Charlie to get through, but Charlie switching. Nice swat here for it all. Brown back and forward between these two. I see them switching up the body to head as well. They're not just when they can't get through in the head, they're switching the body, forcing them to pull their guard down. Wow, that's what a belt and a bout, man.
Nathan's got to keep it on, definitely. Get that brilliant by both boxers, switching up head and body.
Oh, this is brilliant, man. It's so you can't even speak because you're just watching.
Nathan maybe needs to move his head a bit more. He's really saying he's going to get caught.
How can you keep up this level sort of momentum? Mental, man. The two of them have been taking their foot off the gas since we're in. I think they're going to be exhausted by the third round, man. Final few seconds of round number two.
Brilliant second, man.
Wow. And the crowd really get behind them as well.
Yeah, no, definitely, man.
That's what sort of motivates me as well, when this crowd has just gone crazy.
Aye.
So our camera people today is for JTV Goals Youth Group. He was like zooming into the doctor. Don't be zooming into anybody. I can see what you're doing. Just randomly zooming in. He's getting a bit bored doing it. Right,
definitely.
It's only the second time he's walked a camera. I think he's there alright.
Aye.
So what's your year looking like? I know I spoke to you before. What have we got to see? Gold, is that what you're aiming for?
Gold,
you need to open up the Dooley's bank for all this gold you're planning on bringing back.
Exactly.
The all bank the gold, of Dooley's.
Exactly.
Archie will just have a big vault. Archie will just have a big vault underneath the gym with all this gold.
Medals and all that, man.
So you go third and final round, Nathan Lewis from Western District in the blue corner, and Chara Runchbat. And the red from the northwest of England.
Here we go. I think it's a very close fight. I think it's going to come down to the last round.
Oh my god, man.
Caught by Nathan.
You keep going.
Oh, shot by both boxers. Brilliant effort by Nathan. This is definitely coming into the last round.
And I don't know who made this matchup, man, but credit to them as well for finding the two of them. But this is what you want to see in a main event, isn't it?
Exactly.
We've seen something similar in the Dooley show.
The Dooley's home show, that was some fight.
Yeah, Abe Brenton was, incredible, man.
Becoming a bit of a slumfest.
The thing is, there's not really much more the corner can do, because the two of them are just getting it their all. You can't really fault either one of them.
Aye, definitely. As long as you're listening to whatever your coaches are telling you and whatever happens, the results, whatever that is. Great back and forth by both of them, man.
is a great man. This is a great talker about, man, definitely, man.
Heard a few sayings around number two as this crowd is on their feet.
Brilliant.
Wow. Wow. Well done to both boxers there, Lucas Shun. Thanks so much for talking to me. I'll grab the winner in just a second. We'll pass to Gregory Houston in the ring with the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, was that a great bout to end the day? Please, let's hear it for both boxers. After three rounds, the winner on a 3-2 split decision in the blue corner. And ladies and gentlemen, please, let's hear it for Channel Impact! Okay, ladies and gentlemen, remember we've got our best boxer awards, so we'll get them just now.
And while they sort out the best boxer award, joining me ringside, Nathan Lewis. Nathan, what an...
Make a fight when I don't need to, but I just like to fight and make it a bit of a war. But he was tough on a fought, definitely.
He did come out a bit cocky, innit? He came out like a wee bit, right? And I was like...
I fought him twice before, so...
What have you?
So I beat him, and then rematched him in his show in Carlisle. And they gave it to him in a 3-2 split. But... So that one there was the end. That was a trilogy, so...
Bro, man, will we see yous again?
Mate, it's amateur boxing. Just not in Carlisle. Not in Carlisle.
Where are we going to see you next, though?
I'm thinking the next big thing will be the Western District Seniors Elites in November, so probably that for something big, but hopefully I can get fights, you know what I mean? I need fights, that's what I need. So anything that's going, I'll be in there, definitely.
Right, my man, anybody you want to give a shout out to?
No, just everyone that came to watch me and watching on the streaming that we've done it. Good win. Hopefully we're back out sooner.
Right, my man Nathan Lewis. Well done, bro. And I'll catch up with you shortly, yeah? So they're just giving out some awards in the ring. Just bear with us a wee second.
Let's conclude today's boxing. Thanks everyone for coming along. Have a safe journey home. We'll see you again soon.
And guys, that's it from us at JTV Live. Don't forget, if you do want to order any of the bouts, messages, it's £35 for an edit. But you can watch this.